In 2003, the Bothell High School Cougars went into battle together. Brothers, bound by a single goal.
Let's go, Blue Train!
Bloodied and battered, they grappled and fought for yards in a game measured by inches. They played because of their passion for the game. A passion so contagious that by the end of the 2003 season, the biggest question was, can Pop Keeney Stadium hold the entire city of Bothell?
Run a quick slant, stick it on him.
Bothell was alive with a passion for one team, one community, one heartbeat, bursting with blue.
Pound it, pound it, pound it, pound it, wide, wide, down your feet.
Entering the 2003 season, many wondered if Bothell would have the talent to successfully defend their King Co title earned the previous year when the Cougars won their first ever league championship by going undefeated in conference play during their fantastic season to remember.
Queen left yak, 44 blasts, on it, ready!
In fact, it wasn't really much of a surprise when the so-called experts predicted that the 2003 edition of the Bothell Cougars could never reach the heights of last year's team. After all, Coach Tom Bainter returned only 8 starters on offense and defense.
Here we go. I-right trap check.
Here we go. I-right trap check on it, right!
What we decided, instead of being the defending champ that stood on top of the hill and knocked down all people who are trying to take our crown away, we decided to start at the bottom with them. Instead of people knocking at us, we were going to knock down them and climb and scratch and claw our way to the top again. And I'm very pleased with the way they took that attitude and ran with it.
The strength of the 2003 team was its large senior class. Many of these players had been together for as long as 10 years in the Bothell Cougar youth football program. 2003 would mark their last year together on a football field, a last opportunity to prove themselves as a team and to meet the many challenges the 2003 season would ultimately present.
When we saw the work of our younger athletes, our inexperienced athletes, and how hard they worked to become better, we knew that we were going to be pretty good.
Inglemore versus Bothell. The Spaghetti Bowl was served up early as the 2003 season opener, with the Vikings hosting the Cougars before an enthusiastic Pop Keeney crowd of over 6,000 fans. This game was viewed as a big test. The Vikings were regarded as a much improved team. In fact, many had picked the Cougars as underdogs in this early season North Shore matchup. Trailing 3-0, quarterback Tony Gardner connected with fellow senior Russ Wacker for the first touchdown of the 2003 season. In his first varsity start, Gardner threw for 168 yards and 3 touchdowns. The Cougars took a 14-10 lead into halftime when Gardner hit on what was to be the first of many 2003 TD strikes to senior wide receiver Travis McKee. The Cougars had passed their first test. It was an important first step that would take them back to the top and prove that the 2003 Cougar football team could repeat as King Co champions.
It was a tremendous way to start the season, and we passed our first test.
Week two saw the Cougars make their first road trip of the season to Redmond to face the Mustangs. The Cougars totally dismantled Redmond. On offense, quarterback Tony Gardner capped Bothell's second drive of the game with a 15-yard scoring pass to Brendan Gallisher, who led the Cougars with 6 receptions for 80 yards. On Redmond's next offensive play, Riley Mahaffey intercepted the Redmond quarterback and returned it to the Mustangs' 10-yard line. 2 plays later, Bart Ward found the end zone on a 10-yard run and a 14-0 lead. The defense was stellar on this night, limiting Redmond to a paltry 105 yards total offense while scoring 2 touchdowns of their own. Senior safety Nate Baker, who'd end the season leading the league in interceptions, picked one off and took it for 40 yards for the Cougars' 3rd touchdown of the second quarter. And then, in the second half, a vicious hit on the Redmond ball carrier by strong safety Russ Wacker knocked the ball loose. Senior quarterback Mark Lausch picked it up and returned it 50 yards to complete the scoring for Bothell. Final score, Bothell 43, Redmond 0. A total team victory. In week 3, it was back to Pop Keeney, where under a full head of steam, the blue train rolled over the Roosevelt Rough Riders. Tony Gardner and Travis McKee were in sync all night long. McKee hauled in 3 touchdown passes and finished the night with 8 catches for 158 yards. Bart Ward had 13 carries, 76 yards for the Cougars. Junior running back Brett Wilcox scored 2 touchdowns for Bothell on runs of 39 and 62 yards in the fourth quarter. Wilcox finished with 110 yards on 3 carries. And for the second week in a row, Coach Bainter could clear the bench and get valuable playing time for the reserves. Final score, Cougars 54, the Rough Riders 7. In week 4, the undefeated Blue Train rolled into Kirkland for a game with Lake Washington. The Cougars found the end zone early and often, remarkably scoring touchdowns on each of their first 7 possessions. Tony Gardner was awesome, completing his first 11 passes and finishing with 13 completions in 15 attempts for 317 yards, 268 of those coming in the first half. Travis McKee had another big night, 7 catches for 195 yards and 3 touchdowns. The Bothell defense did the rest, shutting down the vaunted Lake Washington passing attack. With the victory, the Cougars went 4-0, proving to any doubters that they would contend for another league championship.
Our offense scores every possession it has in the first half. Our defense gets a shutout. What a tremendous game that was for both units, but what it did for us is it just gave us the confidence that we were looking for and that we knew we had, but now everybody really believed.
Week 5, band night at Pop Keeney. The game versus Wesco powerhouse Lake Stevens marked the beginning of an important phase of the Cougars' 2003 season. In what was becoming routine, quarterback Tony Gardner got the Blue Train offense rolling with a touchdown toss to Travis McKee, this one covering 20 yards. When the defense needed big plays, someone stood up. Russ Wacker had 2 interceptions. Junior Nick Jones had 2 sacks on the same possession, including this one that forced a fumble that junior Carl Ridlon Moore picked up and returned 26 yards. Carl was lost for the rest of the season with a broken leg on this play. The defense turned Lake Stevens away time and time again. Still, with only 2 minutes remaining, Bothell found themselves protecting an 18-10 lead when Bart Ward's second sack of the night helped ice the game. On Bothell's next play, Nick Jones took a handoff and ran 38 yards up the middle for the Cougars' final touchdown. Bothell's D had totally clamped down, limiting the Vikings to only 17 yards rushing for the night while forcing 8 turnovers, intercepting 6 passes, recovering 2 fumbles to go along with 5 quarterback sacks. When it was all over, this was a night to celebrate a good win versus a good team and a fitting game to salute Coach C's Cougar defense. In week 6, it was Bothell versus Ballard. Before the season, Kinko coaches had picked Ballard to win the conference title, and rightfully so, given the Beavers' depth of talent, which included 4 Division I college recruits. As the Cougars prepared to board the buses for their trip downtown, they knew everything was on the line. It was to be the Kinko Conference Showdown of the Year. This much anticipated game provided the backdrop as Tom Bainter and his team hosted Bothell High School's first ever Cougar football reunion the night before the big game in the school's gym.
D-Hawks talked to me, we met for coffee, and he talked about this reunion, and wouldn't it be fun to get all of the former Bothell Cougars together to have a part of it, play a little role in it, and say, you know, hey, this is my old school, and I'm very proud of what they're doing now and where they've gone.
I'm Bud Erickson, class of 1934, and I'm very happy to have this coach.
We stress to our kids when they graduate, once a Cougar, always a Cougar. It's hard for them to comprehend what that means in the future because right now they're still a part of our team. I think the reunion gave them a sense of what that truly means.
They're winners, and by golly, I think we got to be proud of them. Very well.
Bothell versus Ballard, a rainy Saturday night in Seattle's Memorial Stadium. A playoff atmosphere pitting Kinko's number 1 versus number 2, the preseason favorite led by a strong group of Division I high-profile players against a bunch of no-names from Bothell. In a contest that would surprise many people, the game was a battle that would be won on defense. Before a large Bothell contingent, including alumni, one score was all the Cougars would need against a potent Ballard offense that had averaged over 32 points per game entering the night. Behind an offensive line that dominated the night, fullback Nick Jones carried 7 times for 41 yards on a 15-play, 75-yard drive that he capped with a 14-yard touchdown run up the middle of the Beavers' defense. Four of Ballard's drives ended on downs. With 3 minutes remaining, Ballard quarterback Cole Morgan threw 4 passes into the end zone from the Bothell 17-yard line, but all fell incomplete. The last one batted down by Travis McKee. Nate Baker's interception in the final minutes sealed the victory. Final score, Bothell 7, Ballard 3. The victory over the Ballard Beavers established the Cougars as an emerging team with not only a hunger for excellence, but also the will to win. The win also put the unbeaten and 5th-ranked Cougars 1 victory away from securing their 2nd straight Kinko Conference championship, setting the stage for a battle against neighborhood rival Woodinville.
You know what? You got a chance next week to break last year's team's record. You go week 7 and clinch Kinko by beating Woodinville, a North Shore opponent. That's a week earlier than we did it last year. That's a lot of incentive to come out and really work our butts next week.
All season long, the Cougars had heard themselves referred to as defending conference champs. and all season long, the Cougars had seen it differently. They would have to scratch and claw their way back to the top. So it was on a mid-October night in a matchup against Woodinville that will long be remembered. The 2003 Cougars would complete their journey back to the top of the Kinko Conference.
Fear nothing tonight. Don't fear the outcome. Don't fear a down, a distance, a play. Relish every moment. Play with great, great Cougar pride.
In front of a raucous capacity spirit night crowd at Pop Keeney, the game would play out in typical Cougar fashion.
You guys gotta block the tails off.
A punishing ground attack.
Take the pump, okay? Trips right, right.
An efficient passing game.
Tighten a little bit if you want to, but just remember, that's how you read.
And with what was becoming a trademark of this team, an extremely strong and opportunistic defense. Bothell's first score of the evening was this beautiful 36-yard slant to senior receiver Zach Hecker. By halftime, Zach had 5 catches for 86 yards, and the Cougars had built a 14-0 lead. The defense, meanwhile, was doing what it had been doing best all season long, creating turnovers by recovering a pair of fumbles and intercepting highly touted Woodinville quarterback Matt Tuiasosopo twice, while limiting him to just 44 yards on 15 very tough carries. When the defense forced Woodinville to punt late in the game, senior D lineman Scott LaBrash recovered a bad snap for a touchdown, and Woodinville's chances were due. As zeros approached on the game clock, the Spirit Night crowd began to celebrate what the Cougars were about to achieve, the repeat. Back-to-back Kinko titles. Indeed, Bothell had defeated Woodinville 28-14 to claim its second consecutive 4A Kinko Conference Football Championship. Long after the fans filed out of the stands, Bothell players lay on their backs at midfield and stared into the dark sky with goofy smiles on every face. After celebrating with coaches and students after the game in the school gym, the number 6 ranked, undefeated Cougars would wake up the following morning as Kinko 4A conference champions for the second time in as many seasons. The win established Bothell as a bona fide football power.
We knew we were going to be good, but we found out as the season went along that we're going to be great, and that was the fun part, to see these kids come together. And you know, we knew that they liked each other. They loved football. They had the passion. They were determined. They were dedicated. There was no question there. It's just, you always wonder how a group of 95 kids are going to come together and act together. And this group did that better than any team I've ever been a part of.
All that remained on the Kinko schedule were senior night and a game versus the Eastlake Wolves and homecoming and the Franklin Quakers. Bothell demolished both teams while getting valuable playing time for reserves. The Cougars had finished the regular season undefeated. The table was set for the 2003 Washington State football playoffs and a run to the state championship. In a coincidental twist of fate, the playoffs would begin with a rematch against Capital from Olympia. Last year, Capital beat Bothell in the Class 4A state quarterfinals on the strength of a trick play late in the game, the hook and ladder. Nobody, it seemed, would let the Cougars forget. With that memory still burning in their minds, the number 3 ranked Cougars went into the game seeking to fulfill the promise of taking care of unfinished business with Capital. Before a supercharged atmosphere at Pop Keeney, the Cougars were primed and ready to rumble. On the game's first play, junior strong safety Brett Wilcox recovered a Capital fumble. 4 plays later, Tony Gardner hooked up with the 6'5" McKee on a 26-yard fade route in the left corner of the end zone. The offensive floodgates were now open. Quarterback Gardner finished 18 of 24 and 235 yards. Receiver Travis McKee finished with 6 catches, 64 yards, and a pair of touchdowns. Zach Hecker added 5 catches for a game-high 139 yards. Running back Bart Ward rushed for 85 yards, 3 scores. Adding a defensive touchdown off of an interception was linebacker Brendan Gallisher. The interception was Bothell's 34th takeaway of the season. And when sophomore fullback Nico Wacker rumbled into the end zone to finish Bothell's scoring bonanza at a perfect 50, the mission was complete. Final score, Bothell 50, Capital 12. There wasn't a trick play in the world that could stop the Blue Train on this Friday night.
We really felt like somebody upstairs was helping us out, matching us up with Capital again, and giving us an opportunity to lay to rest forever the hook and ladder and to create new memories of our game against Capital.
Bothell versus Bethel, a game for the ages. The home stands filled an hour before kickoff. Fans stood 3 and 4 deep around the field, and many watched from behind the chain link fence along 188.
Kick receiver to fence. It's golden on the defense. You gotta kick this way. Go,
baby. All to just get a glimpse of the action. Pop Keeney would rock tonight. Bethel moved into Bothell territory late in the first quarter, but their golden opportunity was stolen away by Bothell cornerback Mark Lausch. Mark stepped in front of the receiver, intercepted the pass, and raced 60 yards the other way. Lausch's return led to Nolan Smith's 22-yard field goal. On the next possession, the Cougars forced a Bethel punt. Then, using 9 straight running plays, ran the lead to 10-0 with 3 minutes remaining in the first half when running back Bart Ward took it 14 yards to the house. The relentless Cougar defense, magnificent all night, continued to shut down Bethel, handing the offense another opportunity before intermission. A key play on this possession was a 27-yard run by Bart Ward to the Bethel 10. The Cougars hit pay dirt 2 plays later when Tony Gardner connected with Travis McKee in the right corner of the end zone for an 11-yard TD. the Cougars took a 17-0 halftime lead into the locker room, where Coach Bainter emphasized that the game was far from over.
It's going to be a fist fight the rest of this game. It's going to be toe-to-toe, slap each other in the head, punch you in the mouth, and the toughest son of a gun is going to be playing next week. You make sure that's us.
Let's go.
On a whistle win. Word!
A big turning point in the game came in the third quarter, with Bethel threatening on the Cougar six and facing fourth and two, they elected to go for it. But a gang-tackling Cougar defense rose to the challenge and stopped the Braves running back a half yard shy of the first down marker. The dagger was the 96-yard drive that followed. Tight end Brendan Gallisher set up the Cougars' third TD with a 52-yard catch and run to the Bethel 37. Four plays later, Gardner found Hecker just in front of the goalpost for a 15-yard TD pass. Senior Nolan Smith's third extra point gave the Cougars a 24-0 lead with 3:27 remaining. Later, Nick Jones blasted through the Bethel line for a 5-yard TD run on fourth and two to complete the final Cougar score. The Bothell defense, the best in Kinko 4A in 2003, was similarly effective. The Cougars held Bethel's 1,500-yard rusher Zach Fletcher to just 26 yards on 11 carries and intercepted quarterback James Wright three times. In front of what many old-timers said was the largest crowd ever at Pop Keeney Stadium, the Cougars had dominated once again to upset the number one-ranked Bethel Braves. And, like after every game, Bothell players ran to their fans to begin the chant that would rise into the night air and echo throughout Pop Keeney and beyond. The cry of a town's love affair with a high school football team. Next up, another undefeated team, the Olympia Bears. With Pop Keeney filled to the rafters and beyond, the large turnout was a testament to the big game implications of this cold winter evening's contest. The Cougars, it seemed, were poised to finish off the Bears and advance to the state semifinals the following week. On this Friday night, it was as if you could stare into his young eyes and smell his sweat. You could almost hear his breath inches away in the trenches. And then, high school boys in man-to-man combat, muscle and bone, in a battle for a few yards of turf. There's no game like this game. Power, speed, grace, and courage. In a war of huge hearts. They played because they love this game even more than we do. Every autumn, the sounds of football rise from Pop Keeney to every corner of our community, from moms and dads to students cheering in the stands. And at the peak of our passion for football are the Cougars from Bothell. Pride is built over time. For the second year in a row, the Cougars had ignited a community. With a standing room only crowd of over 8,000 people, Bothell went toe to toe with another undefeated team, the Olympia Bears. But in the end, time would run out on the Blue Train, ending a dream and the high school football careers of 33 seniors. In 2003, the Bothell Cougars had posted their second consecutive 11-1 season, and claim back-to-back Kinko championships. But oh, what they wouldn't have given for one more play on this Friday night. The heartache from this loss would loom over the team, their families, their friends for many days, even months to follow. But what everyone will remember forever are those autumn Friday nights where everyone from all corners of the community, young and old, every walk of life, every faith and creed and color, would gather as one, a community's voice rising in unison, cheering on and celebrating our young men. One team, one community, one heartbeat bursting with blue. We'll be right back.